this is Anurag Kashyap and welcome to my film library. And here are the five filmmakers I would very strongly recommend. This is Samuel Fuller. All his films are here. And this is a box set that just came out of these, his very rare movie. And Samuel Fuller is a filmmaker whose films, he's a noir filmmaker who's also made some extremely, extremely controversial movies that were blacklisted in Hollywood also at the time. And he also wrote one book, which actually officially got published last year, much years after his death. There's another filmmaker that my go-to filmmaker is Fritz Lang. And this is the whole of Fritz Lang. Right, I'm slowly, the ones that are coming out on Blu-ray, I'm replacing the DVDs with the Blu-ray. So Fritz Lang, and most of him is now available on a Blu-ray. So this is a great box set you should get. And Fritz Lang is God, by all means. And you see his films and you'll realize all the cinema that we see today, from a Marvel to the big mainstream movies, somewhere always go back to Fritz Lang. Everything, all the Nolan, all the Fincher, everyone goes back to Fritz Lang. He's the man who's defined cinema for us. Then there is Jean-Pierre Melville. And finally, he's also now available all on Blu-ray. And Jean-Pierre Melville is right here. And he's all on Blu-ray now. And there's six films here and the three outside. Jean-Pierre Melville is the best thriller chase films that he has made. And there are many films that he has made. किसी ने चुरा ली. Another filmmaker that I would very strongly recommend is it's not really a filmmaker, but this is something that I believe everybody should watch. The big inspiration behind Martin Scorsese being a filmmaker also, and these Yakuza papers. This is literally six films where you understand the whole Japanese crime kind of a history of it, and it's very rarely available, but this is something that one filmmaker should see. This whole style of filmmaking is what influenced all the Bourne movies, Paul Greengrass. When you see a whole lot of indie filmmakers making thriller, it all goes back to him and Yakuza papers. And he's a filmmaker who's that, the way he, the kinetic energy of that style of making films and editing and putting it together and following the characters, and this whole, it's all here. There's another filmmaker that I would very, very strongly recommend, and I would recommend his early films, which I think people don't know, is, kaise nikalna padega usko, I have to help, is a very popular Japanese filmmaker, Kurosawa, but you have to see his early films. His very, very early films. Films before he, before the world discovered him. And this is available in Criterion. And there's a whole different Kurosawa that you have not seen. It's all here. Aur kya bataun? Bahut saare, I can just go on. Koei Brothers, Koei Brothers is another, the best animation that you will see, the kind of animation that, if you've seen this new Netflix show, Love, Death and Robots, so when you see Koei Brothers, you'll understand everything has a genesis somewhere. And Koei Brothers did animation with broomsticks, with paper, the cutting the books and giving it shape, and some incredible animation they have done. And you have to see, and they made the two feature films also, other than 15-20 minute animation. A lot of movies also I collect because to do screenings, because these films are very hard to get, and most OTT platforms are so driven by profit, there's some great cinema that is not there. So for me, it's very important that the films stay in some kind of a physical form and they're there for generations to watch, because most of these box sets also, when they come out, they don't stay forever unless they're on Criterion. Some of them, some companies have totally stopped publishing some of the movies. Like, when Burning came out, all his earlier films people started looking for. And the company put out a tweet saying that we have lost a license to those films because all Lee Tang Dong's film, early films, people didn't watch them and they didn't buy it. And there's no profit in there. So company said, these are the last copies floating around, please keep. If you find it, just keep it, because then otherwise there's no other way to find his early films. And it was a very sad tweet from a movie publishing company. So there are a lot of movies that are lost. So that's why I like to, even like if I've seen a film, I'll buy it. Or if I've seen a film at a festival, I buy it, because that's my indirect way of paying for a film that I saw for free. And so a lot of films you'll see, they just stay in sealed pack until somebody wants to watch them. I stopped counting at 10-20,000.